My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. Yeah. And my belongs to you, and you deserve it, and you deserve it, and you deserve it, and you deserve it. Say my hallelujah, my hallelujah belongs. Say all of the glory,
all of the glory belongs to you.
Say all of the glory,
yeah, all of the glory belongs to you.
Say all of the glory,
all of the glory belongs.
You deserve it. don't get tired now. Somebody give God a good praise. Come on, I know you're just coming out of Thanksgiving, but can somebody enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise? Come on, I know you can do a little bit better than that. Somebody ought to Shabbat our Lord on this morning. Come on, don't act like you're too cute to give God his due praise. Amen. You ought to give him what he deserves. You ought to give him what he deserves. Amen. You were created to worship. Do you hear me? You were created to worship. You were created to worship. God is a good God. Amen. Good of a God to sit down on his praise. Amen. I don't know about you, but I won't allow a rock to cry out in my place. Amen. We giving the devil his eviction notice on this morning. Amen. Come on, put your hands together and bless our God. Amen. Thank you, praise team, for those wonderful renditions. Let's give it up for them. Amen. Good morning, St. Aubyn. And this is St. Albans Baptist Church, where our pastor and reverend is Reverend Archie F. Manning. Come on now. While you're there, let's give it up for his first only leading lady, Lady Elizabeth Manning. Amen. Let's clap it up for First Lady and the entire First Family. Amen. Our scripture of the week is, I will sing of the mercies of the Lord forever. With my mouth will I make known thy faithfulness to all generations. For I have said, mercy shall be built up forever. Thy faithfulness shall thou establish in the very heavens. That's from Psalms 89, 1 through 2. Call to worship, O Zion, the bringest good tidings. Get thee up in the high mountain, O Jerusalem, that bringest good tidings. Lift up thy voice with strength. Lift it up. Be not afraid. Say unto the cities of Judah, behold your God. Amen. That's from Isaiah 49. Amen. 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 You may take your seats, but if you are a visitor, please remain standing. Do we have any visitors in this place? All right. I see you. I see you. I see you. I see you. Amen. Amen. We got any visitors online? We want you to type in the chat. I'm visiting. I'm visiting. Hey, hey. Please remain standing. Please remain standing. I'm sorry. Amen. On behalf of St. Albans Baptist Church and Reverend Archie Manning, we want to welcome you into this place. We are so excited and delighted that you chose us to join this morning. Amen. You already dressed up looking cute, so we're just going to give God a good praise. Amen. Amen. And if you're joining us online, we thank you for joining us. And we ask that you come back next Sunday, in the next one, in the next one, in the next one. Amen. So when the invitation is extended, we ask that you give God your heart and give Pastor your hand and join in this wonderful house of Zion. Amen. Now, St. Albans, can we please stand and greet our beautiful visitors? By Sister Gloria Manning. Amen. Say amen as she comes.
Good morning, St. Albans. Hi, I'm Gloria Manning, pastor's daughter. Good morning. Nice to see you all. Please let us bow our heads and close our eyes for a word of prayer. Most gracious and loving Father, we thank you for letting us be here today, for waking us up, for putting clothes on our backs and shoes on our feet. We pray for those who are sick and ill and could not make it today, Lord God. And I just want to say thank you for letting us all be here to hear your word. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Your prayers. Amen. 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 As we stand for our opening hymn, number 22, Come We That Love the Lord. Amen.
Come we that
by a pastoral emphasis by Reverend Archie F. Manning. Come on, say amen as she comes. Let's clap it up. Come on.
Good morning, St. Albans. Ooh, 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 ooh. 1 second. May you please stand for the Advent Litany. We enter into the Advent season, turning our attention to you, God. We acknowledge the darkness that is within us and in the world. Father, forgive us.
We acknowledge the suffering, tragedy, and pain by which humanity is afflicted, which seem at times to overwhelm us. Draw near to us, O God.
We consider the mystery of your ways, that you choose to send our Savior as an innocent baby and not as a warrior or a king, as one who humbly accepted suffering and humiliation on the cross and called it glory. Our hope is in Jesus Christ, the Messiah.
We choose at this moment to focus our attention on hope, the hope of Jesus Christ, to restore all that is broken in the world, the hope of new life and resurrection.
Grant, O God, that when Jesus comes again, Christ may find us waiting in expectation, our souls quieted, our hearts open. In Christ, all things are made new, and we look forward to the day our hope is fulfilled, each other heart reconciled. Amen.
Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Good morning, St. Albans. Today is a beautiful day. Some of y'all are a little sleepy, too much turkey, I think. I don't know. A little too much, what's that? Tryptophan. Tryptophan in the turkey. But God bless you. You look good, St. Albans. You look good. And to our visitors, we welcome you. God bless you. Thank you for joining us this Sunday. We pray that you will enjoy the service and that if there is a note sung or a prayer prayed or a word spoken, that your heart would be turned toward and say yes to God's yes and join us here at the great St. Albans Baptist Church, the church with a warm welcome. You are more than welcome. God bless you. God bless you. And to those online, God bless you. Continue to keep worshiping with us online, and we pray that you will join us here in the beautiful borough of Queens in St. Albans, New York, where you will be welcomed warmly, and we look forward to you worshiping with us soon. You may participate in worship by communicating in the chat, any prayer requests, any praise reports, any amens, just put it in the chat. We will respond. God bless you, and we thank you for joining us. And now it is time for some pastoral words. The 2023 leaders and officers, for the calendar year 2023. We thank you so much to those who have already reached out to the nominating committee and expressed their interest to serve in one of the following positions. You may all know, I love the sound of babies. Let her go ahead and shout it out. So, Sunday school superintendent and assistant. We are looking for trustees, treasurer and assistant, church clerk, financial and benevolent secretary. We are still looking for additional volunteers, so please reach out to one of the following members. Deaconess Ruby Boyd, God bless you, Sister Nina Torres, and Sister Patricia Bridgelaw. They will provide you with more detailed information about each position posted. And Monday nights, we have been having a good time. 7:30. What happens at 7:30? Bible study. And right now we've put a pin in John, and we are now focusing and turning our attention to Advent. What it is, what Advent is, what does it mean to wait for the Lord? Is it a passive waiting or is it an active participatory waiting? So for this season, that's what we will be focusing on. And Wednesday nights, prayer meeting with our own deacon and deaconess, Boyd. God bless you, the hour of power. We ask that you, yes, continue to support and come in on and pray. Pray with us. You can pray with us on your way home from work. Tune us in right on the Zoom. You can get the link They are given out on our, if you do not get the link, that means we don't have your information. So please stop by the office and provide us with your information so that you may be kept abreast of what is happening in the life of St. Albans. And our community Christmas toy distribution, December 10th. Sister Debbie Miller, where are you, Sister? Hey, there she is. Sister Debbie Miller is waving her hand for the Christmas toy drive distribution. It will be held on December 10th. So please see her for information on drop-off locations and specific items that she still may be in need of. I believe we're looking for hats, gloves, scarves of all types, sizes, and genders, male and female, amen? Babies even, socks, anything that we have. How many bags of toys did you get already? 18 bags full of toys. To God be the glory for that. So we are continuing to collect. We want to make a powerful impact in the lives and put a smile on a child's face. Amen. Amen. So the Christmas season is upon us, and worship services and celebrations are being planned. We will have, St. Albans, an SABC Christmas. We're going to have an SABC Christmas here. Christmas Eve, we're going to have a candlelight service of carols and singing and poetry and spoken word and dance. I'm claiming it. I haven't talked to the dance ministry. But yeah, we're going to have dance. We're going to have it all. It's just going to be wonderful celebration of the coming of Jesus Christ and the forecoming of when he comes again. Amen. And then on Christmas morning, we are going to have an elevated, high worship service for Christmas. Christmas falls on Sunday. Amen. Christmas falls on Sunday. You better not stay home. You come to the house of God and you worship him on the day that we have elected for his birthday celebration. Amen. Amen, St. Albans. And not only do you come, I want you to bring two or three people with you. It is going to be a powerful service, a powerful worship service. And let's give God what God is due. Amen. God bless you. Now is the time in our worship service where we all can participate. It is offering time, St. Albans. It is now time to give unto the Lord just a portion of what God has given to us so freely. And let us now prepare to receive the Lord's tithes and offerings. Scripture teaches that each one must give as they have decided in their heart to give. This is a heart thing, church. Not under compulsion, but not reluctantly, for the Lord loveth a cheerful giver. So bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in mine house. And the Lord says, prove me now herewith, saith the Lord of hosts. I will not open the windows of heaven and pour you out such a blessing that there shall not be room enough to receive it. Let us pray. Lord, we come before you today to present your tithes and your offerings back to you in faith as an act of worship. We believe in your word, God. And we honor it by putting our faith into action through the ministry of giving. We thank you for your many wonderful blessings. And we believe that we shall have what you have promised us. Help us to be good stewards over that which you gave us. Help us that all of these resources may be used to the upbuilding of your kingdom. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, we ask, and we give thanks. Amen. Amen. All right, young people. God bless you. It is. I'm telling you, that turkey is something else. It'll get you. So the young choir will come down first, followed by those who are seated in the balcony. They will come down, come this way and around. And then those who are in the lower sanctuary, God bless you. You will be directed by the ushers. All right. Let us all be cheerful in our giving. God bless you. Thank you.
by the ushers. God bless you.
Come from thee, O God, and of thine own have we given thee. You may be seated. And now we will have a very special presentation. Our praise dancer, one of our praise dancers, will be coming down. Give her a hand as she comes. Sister Winter Reed will be coming for a liturgical dance. God bless you, and thank you so much for sharing.
Now we're here.
You cause change to break. Hey, you cause change to break. Hey, you cause.
throne, put your hands together for a God who performs miracles. Hallelujah. Has he moved mountains for you? Has walls come down because of his word? Do I have a witness in here about the mountain moving God that we came to worship this morning? I would not sit on my seat. I would get on my feet and tell him, thank you for moving the mountains out of my way. Thank you for the miracles. I'm walking. It's a miracle. I'm here today. Hallelujah. Just give him some praise right now. Give him 30 seconds of praise right now for being a mountain mover. Thank you.
Give it up for Winter Reed one more time. Amen. Amen. We thank God for the God in her. Amen. Amen. He's still in the mountain moving business, church. He's still in the miracle working business, church. How many of you believe that in this place today? Amen. Amen. He's a good God. Amen. At this time, are going to be led further in worship by a selection by none other but our sister Nadia Williams. Amen. Can we clap it up as she comes? Followed by her, we'll be having a word by none other than Reverend Archie Manning. Amen.
Good morning, church. Anybody know God is able?
Exceedingly, abundantly, above all. You can ask or think according to the power that worketh in you, God is able to do just what he said he would do, and he's gonna fulfill every promise to you. And don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you when he's able.
Just lift your hands.
Yeah, 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 he's able. Don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you when he's able. Oh, yeah, yeah, he's able.
Can everybody just sing that with me?
say God is able, just what he said. He's gonna fulfill every promise. Don't you give up on God. No, no. He won't give up on you and say he's able. Don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. No, no, he's able. Oh, 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 he's able. Say, oh, 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 he's able. Now say he's able.
He's able.
He's able. Say he's able, he's able. Say he's able. Say he's able. Say he's able. He's able. Now say God is able to do just what he said he would do. He's gonna fulfill every promise. Don't you give up on God. Oh, 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 he's able. Now say, oh, 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 he's able. Say, oh, 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 he's able. Now say, oh, oh, oh. Don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you when he's able. He's able. Because he won't give up on you. No, no, he's able.
Yeah. Don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. He's able. He's able. God bless you, Sister Nadia Williams, for blessing us with that, and for all who have participated in this wonderful worship service this morning. God is good. He's able, and his mercy endures forever. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. Can we just sing a little bit of Amazing Grace? Amazing. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. that anybody's testimony this morning? Was blind, but now I see. I see. God bless you. Thank you for amazing grace. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Most gracious and loving God, we are ever mindful to give your name the glory, the honor that it is due. Because if it had not been for you, oh God, where would we be? Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for bringing us into your sacred space that we may worship you in the only way that you will accept it, and that is in spirit and in truth. So right now, as we come to this sermonic moment in your worship service, we pray that you will bless your servant. Break him, mold him, and shape him into what you would have him to be, so that your word would touch the heart of your people. So hide me behind the cross, so that all of thee, less of me, would be seen, heard, and felt in this place. And if there is one among us who is on the verge of decision, who is on the fence of submitting and committing their lives to you, oh God, we pray that you would nudge them. Give them a little Holy Ghost push so that they may surrender all to you. It is in the mighty and matchless, magnanimous, magnificent name of Jesus the Christ that we pray, we ask, and we give thanks. And the people of God said, and the people of God said, amen and amen. Amen. Our text for the morning comes from the Old Testament scripture in the book of Isaiah, which is a very powerful prophet of old, who foretold the coming of Jesus Christ, the suffering and the resurrection of Jesus. The book of Isaiah, in the 40th chapter, we will begin reading at verse 28 and concluding, for our purposes, at the 31st verse. I will be reading from the King James Version because King James just sounds good in my ear. When we study from more authoritative scriptures like the NIV or the NRSV, but sometimes it's just good to hear the poetry of good old King James. Once you found it, please say amen. And if you have not found it yet, please say Bible study. Amen. Amen. And it reads, "Hast thou not known, hast thou not heard, that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youths shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall." Verse 31, "But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint." Amen. The grass withers and the flower fades, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Brothers and sisters, Advent is a season in the church calendar dedicated to the hopeful anticipation of the arrival or the advent of Jesus of Nazareth. In biblical Hebrew, the word wait is better translated the word hope. The word is kavah, Let me hear you practice saying that. Say kava. That word is waiting, but not just any waiting. Waiting with expectancy. Waiting with expectation, but waiting for what? You find this same notion of hope all over the book of Psalms, where these words appear over 40 times. In almost every case, what people are waiting for is God and the long-expected Jesus Christ. Biblical hope is more than wishful thinking. It's not what you hope for. It is who your hope is in. Waiting with expectancy in Jesus, the Bible says, renews our strength, helps us to endure the dark period of waiting. So for this sermonic moment, I would like to preach from the subject, hope. More than wishful thinking. The book of Isaiah has been and still is one of the most universally cherished books in the Old Testament outside of the book of Psalms. The New Testament alludes to Isaiah more than 250 times, and portions of it are directly quoted no less than 50 times. The book of Isaiah is said to be the Bible in miniature form. Today, many people who study the scriptures call the book of Isaiah a miniature Bible for several reasons. For one, the book of Isaiah has 66 chapters, and the Bible has 66 books, so we got some Bible readers. And as God would have it, every chapter of Isaiah is connected chronologically to the book that it represents. The first 39 chapters of Isaiah mirror the first 39 books, or the 39 books of the Old Testament, which depict God's children in exile. The final 27 chapters of Isaiah, like the 27 books that make up our New Testament, tell and foretell what God has done, is doing, and what God will do to deliver God's people. The Old Testament children of Israel, to whom Isaiah is writing, were what my mother would call some hard-headed people. They were caught in a vicious cycle of repeat offenses. See, they would get themselves into trouble, and then they would cry out to God. God would show up and deliver them, and then they'd be all right for a few chapters, and then they would get themselves into more trouble, and then they would cry out to God again, and God would show up and deliver them again, and then they would get themselves into more. You see the picture. You would think that they would learn, but if you keep reading, they get themselves back into something else. They would cry out to God again, but God would show up and deliver them yet again. Hard-headed. In the book of Exodus, God called them a stiff-necked people. But before we get too hard on the children of Israel, my brothers and sisters, don't they sound a lot like us? We get ourselves into trouble, and first thing we do is we cry out to God, and what does God do? God shows up on our behalf, and he rescues us. Thanks be to God. But guess what? We're hard-headed. So sometimes we don't learn our lesson, and we end up getting ourselves back into the same predicament. And then we cry out to God again. But guess what? God shows up again and again and again. Now, in the midst of God having to continually rescue us from ourselves with repeat performances of grace and mercy, while we are waiting, we sometimes doubt that God will do it again. But here it is, God has a way of using these repeat performances of grace and mercy towards us, even in our disobedience, church. Yes, God takes these opportunities to remind us of God's ultimate power and his desire to deliver and rescue his children. Sounds like a good father to me. God is a good God. Aren't you glad to be a child of God? Well, I'm saying is whenever you find yourself getting into something else, remember that it's the same God that got you out of that mess, and he's the same God that can get you out of this mess. In other words, whenever you go through whatever you go through, you ought to go through it with confidence. Why? Because all we have to do is look back on everything that God has already done for us and live in wonderful anticipation of God's power to do it again. This is what Isaiah is reminding the children of Israel in our text this morning, that God has the power to do it again, but not only again, but to do it once and for all through Jesus Christ. The person and the work of Jesus the Messiah are detailed more fully in Isaiah than any of the Old Testament scriptures. Isaiah prophesies that the virgin birth in chapter 7. He prophesies Jesus as the suffering Savior, dying for our sins of the world in chapter 53, and as the eternal God who is the Prince of Peace all through chapter 9. Isaiah gives them all this light, all of this hope, while they are still going through the darkness of exile. He's giving them someone to hope in, St. Albans. See, the children of Israel felt like God had forgotten all about them, and that God had abandoned them and left them in exile on their own, cut off and alone. That's how many people feel, especially around this time of year. Cut off, isolated, and alone. The holiday season is not a joyous time for everyone. For many people, it is a time filled with sadness and dark reflection and loneliness. Many times these dark feelings come from misplacing our hope. Now, I'm not talking about those with serious mental issues, mental health concerns. It is important that we take care of our mental health and see a doctor or licensed therapist. I believe that therapy is an answer to God's prayer. I believe that prayer and therapy, I believe in prayer and therapy. I believe that prayer and proper medication is an answer to our prayers. Amen, church? But sometimes, beloved, we place our hope in things that will ultimately fail us. Things that were not designed to last or sustain us in the first place. We put our hope in our finances. But what happens when the market crashes? Sometimes we put our hope in our abilities and in our careers, but what happens when our abilities fade? We must be careful about where we place our hope. Careful not to make things and make people our idols when we feel far from God. There's no substitute for God. If you choose to look for hope in your abilities and your career, we have to remember this, that no career has ever died for your sins. No boss has ever got up on a cross for you. In fact, if you fail in your career, they may punish you for as long as you work there. Some of us put our hopes in other people, but people, even if they mean well, people will let you down. Even your husband or your wife or your partner or your significant other or your boo thang or your bae, whatever you want to call it, it will put you down. They will disappoint you at some point. But brothers and sisters, it is easy to slip into worshipful adoration and idolization when you are in a relationship, especially if you're in a good marriage. As much as I love my wife, Lord knows I love her, but I have to love Christ more. Watch this. Loving Christ first helps me to love her better. I'm going to say that again. Loving Christ first will help you to love your loved one better. Loving Christ first will help you to love your children better. Loving Christ first will help you to love one another better. Love Christ first. Our hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. The Bible says, hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not nor neither is weary. So why on earth would we put our hope in somebody who needs to take a nap every time they have some turkey? Why would you put your hope in things that need to be rejuvenated and kickstarted? Why would you put your hope in things like the stock market or Bitcoin that fluctuate up and down like a yo-yo? Have you not known, have you not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the Creator, fainteth not, neither is weary? There's power in biblical hope. He giveth power, verse 29. I love it. Verse 29, he giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases their strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and young men shall utterly fall. Biblical hope is more than wishful thinking. Biblical hope is anchored in the Lord. Biblical hope is not youthful optimism. It's the difference between shall and should. Listen. Verse 29, he giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases strength. That's when your hope is anchored in the Lord, anchored in the one that faints not, neither is weary. God will give you some of his omnipotent power. He will give you some of his strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. In these two verses, Isaiah has juxtapositioned the power and the strength of God with the frailty and weakness of humanity. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and young men shall ultimately fall. Now, I know Isaiah was a prophet, but I don't know how much he was around youth or young people. But let me tell you what, this juxtaposition that he paints here, this is a strong contrast. I don't know if you've been around young people a lot. I am. I'm around young people a lot. My wife and I, they are all up in my house, all in my kitchen, all in my refrigerator, always in my car, always dancing around and doing TikToks. I teach, so I'm always with young people all day long. And if you're not around young people, let me tell you a little secret about young people. They seem like they don't ever get tired. But the prophet Isaiah writes, even the youth shall faint eventually. Even the young men shall utterly fall. But I'm so glad that I have enough years behind me to really appreciate the truth of God found in verse 31. They that wait upon the Lord. Do I have any witnesses in here this morning? Upon the Lord shall renew their strength, shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not get weary. They shall walk and not faint. See, that's the difference. There's a difference between wishful thinking and biblical hope. That word wait, we talked about it earlier, that they that wait upon the Lord is that Hebrew word kavah. Kavah is related to the word for cord. And when you pull tightly on a kav, it produces a state of tension that until it's released, there is the kavah. The feeling of tension and expectation while you are waiting for something to happen. And when it happens, there is a release. Wishful thinking, however, talks about what should happen or what you wish could happen. Like when you wish upon a star. But biblical hope talks about what God says shall happen. I'm so glad that the Bible says, they that kavah upon the Lord, they that hope on the Lord shall renew their strength, shall mount up with wings, shall run, shall walk and not faint. That's not wishful thinking, church. That's not positive optimism. Wishful thinking ignores the painful reality of my life. But biblical hope is grounded in my understanding of who God is based on my experiences with God. To do a repeat performance of his grace and his mercy. That's where my hope is. My hope is built on nothing less than the blood of Jesus and his righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but I'm going wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Jesus' name. Mary's baby, Jesus. Born in a manger low, Jesus. Come to set the captive free, Jesus. Walk the streets of Palestine, Jesus. Healed the sick and gave sight to the blind, Jesus. God's greatest gift to mankind, Jesus. My hope is built on who he is, and my hope is built on what he's already done. What'd he do for you, church? He died on an old rugged cross, buried in a borrowed tomb. He descended into hell, but on the third day, he rose from the grave with all power. And now he gives you the power so that you won't faint. And you too have power that you'll have might and give you strength. Strength to wait on him. Strength to endure the tests of time. Strength to withhold the trials of life. On Christ, church. On Christ, the solid rock I stand. All other ground, sinking sand. Not in my ability. Not on my own. For I shall utterly fall. But when I fall, he's there to pick me up. When I fall, he'll pick me up again and again, and I'll mount up with wings as eagles. On your own, you shall utterly fall. But with Christ, there is always hope. There's more love than you can imagine. Peace that surpasses all understanding, and joy, unspeakable joy, everlasting joy. I invite you this morning to experience this hope for yourself, the type of hope that can be found in Christ Jesus. When you make him your Lord and your Savior, don't rely on wishful thinking, wishing that you'll make it into heaven, wishing that you'll be with him in paradise. The song says to be sure, be very sure, that your anchor holds and grips the solid rock. Just don't think that you're gonna make it. Don't think you can do it on your own, living just a moral and decent enough life that you should make it in. Be sure, church. Be very sure. The Bible says that if you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, then you shall be saved. Not should be saved, not might be saved, but you shall be saved. Hope is not wishful thinking. Don't misplace your hope this season. There's power in hope. There's security in hope. So build your hope on things eternal. Have you not known, church? Have you not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of heaven and the ends of the earth, faints not, neither is weary, and that same God is available to you today? Will you surrender? Will you yield to him? Will you let go and let God? Give your life to Christ this morning, church. As we are all standing on our feet, the doors of the church are open. As we sing this hymn of the church, all to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him in his presence daily. The doors of the church are open, man, woman, boy, or girl. If one would step out, stop trying to do it your way and do it God's way, as we sing. All to Jesus I surrender. Thank you. would remain standing, remain standing. Father God, we thank you. We thank you for sending your son, Jesus Christ, on our behalf. A debt that we could not repay and a debt that he did not owe, so that you would redeem your people and draw us back to you, O God. We thank you for this opportunity to worship you in spirit and in truth, to gather together in this house of worship, St. Albans Baptist Church. We thank you for all those who have gathered here in the sanctuary and those who are online. And right now, oh God, we lift up petitions and prayers on behalf of your people. Hear our prayer, oh Lord. Incline thine ear unto us and grant us your peace. Grant us your security. Grant us the power that lives in hoping and laying all of our hope and trust in you. We thank you right now, Lord God, for those who are sick among us, those who are afflicted with pain and disease and discomfort. We pray, oh God, that you would send your comforter right now. Touch what is hurt. Heal what is broken. Mend what is separated. Father God, we thank you for the relationships that we have in the community and the body of Christ. Help us to be good brothers and sisters, to uplift one another in brotherly and sisterly love. Help us to care for one another as you taught us how when you walked amongst us. Help us to see about each other. Help us to be friendly and show ourselves friendly, especially during this time when people are suffering silently in depression. Touch the hearts of your people, oh God. Send your paraclete, your comforter, so that we would know your peace. We thank you, oh God, for those who are bereaved. We pray that you would comfort them. Give us an opportunity to minister unto them, to share your love with them. Father God, we thank you for this world. You gave it to us, and we have left it in turmoil, in shambles, and in almost despair. But there is hope in you that we are not in despair. There is hope in you that we are not shaken, that we shall not utterly fall, because our hope is in you. Receive our prayer, O God. We thank you for resources and finances and the ability to serve in a way that you would have us to. Continue to help us to be good stewards over all that you left us, the world and they that dwell therein. For it all belongs to you, O God, and it's just on loan to us. So give us your wisdom. Give us your understanding. Let us lean not unto our own, because if we left it up to us, we would just mess it up. So we return it back to you. We thank you for the children, O God. We thank you for the children, O God. Those children who served in worship this morning, we thank you for them. We thank you for their families. Lord God, bless their families that they continue to raise them up in the way that they should go, so that when they are old, they will not depart from you. Because this world is almost set up and designed for their demise. The enemy is running wild, but you have already overcome the enemy. He is a defeated foe, oh God. So we thank you. Continue to watch over our senior citizens and elders among us. Help us to honor them. Help us to speak good of them. Help us to listen to their wise counsel and their advice. Oh God, help us to care for them and not leave them alone or lonely and desolate. But, oh God, help us to wrap our arms around them the way you would. Help us to comfort them and care for them the way you would. Help us to be your arms. Help us to be your words. Help us to be your feet, that we may do good, so that thy kingdom would come on earth as it is in heaven. We thank you for the day. We thank you for our daily bread. Thank you for another opportunity to get it right, So as we go into this new week, help us to be a blessing. Help us to that they would know that we are Christians by how we treat them. Not by saying we go to St. Albans, but by being disciples of Jesus Christ and living our lives accordingly. Help us, God, as only you can. In the mighty name of Jesus, the soon coming Christ, we offer this prayer. Amen and amen. You may be seated. God bless you. Well, church, God showed up again. Amen. God bless you. And as we prepare to go down from here, let us continue to care for one another. Let us share the good news of Jesus Christ everywhere we go. Amen.
What a mighty God we serve.
Bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you and grant you with his perfect peace. May his countenance rest upon you both now and forevermore. And the people of God say, amen.